Nice to have options. All right, CBS 4 meteorologist Dave Warren joining us from home. A stormy Memorial Day weekend, Dave.
Yes, we have options as far as the weather goes, either heavy rain or light rain, maybe a little break now and then, but for the most part, it is as rainy and it will get a little heavier here tonight. We could even have some strong storms coming into the area. So be alert, stay alert for the any changing weather. You could have flooding issues. We've seen a few and we're still seeing that flood watch in effect all the way through Monday evening. Now, radar shows right now that we're seeing a little break across parts of Miami-Dade and up into Broward, maybe some light rain, but for the most part, another wave of rain has worked its way through. A little stronger, heavier areas mixed in with that light to moderate rain. So you do get these downpours continuing. I'd like to say this is the end of it, but there's a lot more just to the south that'll be pushing through the area here overnight, tonight, and tomorrow. Stronger areas of rain developing off the coast of Miami-Dade. They'll kind of work their way through, moving from southeast to northwest. They could contain gusty winds and brief heavy rain. Stormy weather there down to the south and a lightning strike or two. In fact, a number of lightning strikes being detected across the Florida Straits. This is what will be working its way through the area overnight tonight and during the day tomorrow as the moisture increases and a little disturbance kind of works its way through. But right now, the Keys could see a gusty storm here in a matter of minutes. Right now, this is our live picture. Looks pretty quiet relative to what is happening there just off to the south. Rain amounts have already been high. This is the big concern here because we could be adding just as much, maybe if not more, to what we've seen already. Close to 4 inches in Miami, could see an additional 3 to 5 inches of rain. Radar estimated rainfall shows the issue. You get these bands of rain that kind of work their way over the same area. So some areas get a lot of rain on either side, maybe not quite as much, but it's this that leads to flooding. And if heavier rain comes in from the south, that could lead to a flash flood warnings being issued. Right now, the flood watch in effect through Monday evening, so we could see more of that here overnight, tonight, and tomorrow. Rain has kept the temperatures down into the upper 70s. We have that southeast surface wind, a little development here across the parts of the Gulf of Mexico. This is an upper level disturbance there with that dotted line that'll kind of swing its way through the air. With that, well up in the atmosphere is out of the southwest. That change in wind direction can lead to these stronger storms developing. So we might have embedded strong to severe storms on top of the heavy rain coming into the area. That is the loop. It'll swing its way through. It looks like it peaks over the area by tonight and tomorrow with the heaviest moisture, the strongest storms, embedded strong storms throughout the day Monday. Now, by Tuesday, it starts to lift out. We get some slightly drier air coming in. That could lead to a little more sunshine in the forecast, but we still have to keep the storms around. On top of the rain we've had, we could see an additional 3 to 4 inches, giving us locally higher amounts there with maybe some areas getting close to 8 inches of rain. So that is leading to the flooding problems. Downpours tonight, embedded strong to severe storms, but the clouds clear out. We have a temperature of 80 degrees tomorrow with these strong storms. And then for the rest of the week, the clouds clear just a bit. We'll get a little more sunshine, but we have to keep these storms in the forecast pretty much each day with these brief downpours. Southeast 15 to 20 knots, 2 to 4 foot seas, choppy in the bays, the extended forecast. Worst day looks to be Monday, unfortunately, there for the holiday. Then sunshine and storms for the rest of the week. Temperatures will be a little warmer into the upper 80s. Back to you.